Hello, my name is Thomas. I'm from investmentexcel.com, a platform where you can download material or perhaps supporting material for economics and finance. Today I will demonstrate how to calculate the price of a path-dependent option with the risk neutrality technique. Particularly, I will look at a group of options called look-back options, and as the state or as the name suggests, the look-back options look back at the observed path of underlying stock prices and do some manipulation in order to create the ultimate price at maturity that has to be compared with the exercise price in the option. All right. This video and the Excel workbook are both available on Investment Excel and Spotify. All right. I will assume an option with the European structure. That is, we only have potential cash flow on maturity, and in this case I have a 5-year option and it's a call, so the long of the option has an upside on the look back price. This structure is governed by a stochastic process of the underlying stock determined from a drift and from a volatility in what we call a geometric Brownian motion. So exactly the same log return model as they use in, for instance, Black-Scholes. We will price this product under the risk neutral measure, which we can do because we assume that this particular option can be replicated in another portfolio, which can be shown to yield only the risk-free return over the entire option living time. So the classical argument for pricing derived products with the risk neutral measure is that we have a replicating portfolio that gives only the 5%, in this case, return, the risk-free return per period and half year per year. So that's the stochastic process, and I'll just, before I just show that in more detail, I will just line up some other features for the option price. We need the price of the stock today because the process has to be fired off from the stock price. It's a Markov process. It has an exercise price of 50. Yeah, and again, flat volatility, flat risk-free rate, and time to maturity 5. And then the dependent structure is defined as the maximum observed price of the underlying stock minus the minimum price observed of the underlying stock. And this calculation is done 5 times, once each year at a predefined date in the year. Doesn't really matter here, it's just once a year. So the call option value, the intrinsic value at maturity, and remember it's European, so it's only relevant at maturity, is the maximum of 0, as it always is. And the difference between the max and minimum observed minus the strike price, which is not 100 as it says here, it's actually 50. So the call option feature has been changed from the standard plain vanilla European call option, where you just have the observed stock price at maturity here minus the exercise price. So this is where the look back comes in, that we look back in, for instance, this path. If we assume that this was the observed path of the stock price over 5 years, first 103.87, then we would take the minimum and maximum. Now I have simulated, and here are the paths, individual paths simulated, and I have 250 simulated paths, and this is enough to be able to see the ultimate price, average price from the Monte Carlo simulation and the law of large number. Let's just see year one, the simulated value. So what I need is the distribution of stock prices at time t equals 1. For that I need the distribution of the underlying log returns, and then I exponentialize. So here I calculate first a log return, and remember it's based on the risk-free rate. This is the drift in the process, and then I exponentialize it. So from a normal distributed log return in the parentheses here, I exponentialize, and the outcome is a log normal price distribution. And of course, the price cannot be negative as it's an exponential function. So for each year, I draw 250 times in this distribution, and I do that all the way. So give me the look back value at maturity 5. So I take the minimum and maximum from this, maximum being this, minimum being, now I have to be careful, being this, and take the difference, which is this. So remember, these are simulated now, but we assume now that this is reality, and we are here at year 5, and we observe this path, this particular path. Then the look back value price would be this, and I calculate this for each draw, and then it's pretty trivial to calculate the option price or option value given as the maximum of 0 and the price value minus the exercise. So again, we simply substitute the normal observed price drawn from a single distribution at maturity, substitute that with this, which is now a complicated distribution based on the four previous distribution and the distribution itself at year 5. In some cases, there are very, very fancy mathematical closed form solutions, but in most cases we have to rely on numerical techniques like the Monte Carlo to price. So the Monte Carlo, now what it does is just to average the price that we would like to find. The price variable, we average all of them, and we find that the average call option price at maturity from where we have to discount is 71.02 So this is the price in 5 years. What we need today is to find a equilibrium price today, and it is an equilibrium price because there is no subjective expectations. There are no risk premia in the model. We are working under the risk neutral measure because of the replication possibilities. So we discount the average call price with the risk-free rate, as we see here. And again, it's a flat structure, so I assume that the replicating portfolio has a return of 5% between each period. So from now to one, from one to two, three, and so forth. This is what traders they do in banks, in the larger banks. They have derivative trading desks, and they of course trade directly on behalf of their clients, but they have their own book, as we say, where they try to take advantage of any mispricing between, for instance, this price here of 55.31 with a replicating portfolio. If there are any misalignment, then there is could be a no arbitrage possibility that the trader can take advantage of. So this is also the whole idea by using this argument, that we know that that the no arbitrage exists, so this should be the correct price. So in the theoretical world here, we assume that this price is correct because there is no such thing as arbitrage in the market. In the market, of course, there are on occasions some possibilities, but the traders, they immediately trade it back, and this is why we can rely on the framework here. All sensitivities in the model, just as in the Black and Scholes model, can be derived by making some discrete adjustments to the relevant parameters. Say we want to calculate the delta, the first derivative, the sensitivity of the option to changes in the underlying, then we could change it up here. We could also build a key figure for the change in the average by using all the simulations here. And the volatility, Vega, raw, theta, and so on. All possible to retrieve just by manipulating up and down the relevant variable. Over here, lastly, you see the simulated payoff at maturity, the famous hockey stick, when you have an option on the upside here, then you have the value is zero all the way to this level here at 50 at the strike, and it goes up. So the strike is here and it goes up, and this is just the payoff profile. Of course, this is not the profit because you have paid up front 55. So the profit the profit curve is different. It will shift upwards and go out and up. So this is just the payoff of the option. All right, this was about look back options and pricing with risk neutrality.